Hey there, this is Kristen from KristenCoaching.com. The topic of today is what to say to your cheating husband, especially to know what to say to him if you want to know if he's truly sorry for what he did. Before we dive into the guts of the topic, I want to remind all of you to please subscribe to my YouTube page if you haven't already, and you'll get a notification and a pop-up every time I create a new video for you. So, basically, you know, it's very important to know how your partner feels after being unfaithful to you, because relationships don't necessarily need to be over as a result of infidelity. And I've mentioned this in many past videos. If you don't want your relationship to be over, it doesn't necessarily mean that it has to be over. There are many couples that do survive infidelity and actually come out on the other side even stronger and better before. I happen to be one of them, and I know many, many other couples who are one of those as well. So there's a lot of factors that go into this, however. So I think a big key issue is for you to be able to assess, you know, the level of sincerity that comes from your partner or your husband after he's cheated, and to really see how remorseful and regretful they are. You want to do this for many reasons, because if they don't care about what they did, if they feel justified, if they feel fine about it, if they don't have any emotions about it, that is a lot more of a huge barrier to be able to overcome to get your relationship back together again. Because there's a lot of, that shows me that there's a lot of emotional distance, there's a lot of justification in there, and you're going to be fighting a huge uphill battle to be able to get your relationship back healthy again and get that trust up. But if your husband is super remorseful and sorry and taking responsibility and all the things that we're going to be talking about in a second, that's a different story, and you have some things that you can actually work with in terms of repairing your relationship. So here's what you are going to do in order to, things that you're going to say to your husband in order to talk about the cheating and know that he's truly sorry. The first thing you need to do is you need to acknowledge that you know about the cheating if you haven't already. I can't tell you how many couples out there where they keep that secret, or they keep that information in. They know that their partner's being unfaithful, but they don't say anything for whatever reason. Listen, you're not going to solve the problem. You're not going to be able to change the situation you are in now unless you make changes and unless you are honest with each other and you tell each other what's going on. So you need to be telling your partner that you know about it, that you know, you need to get it out in the forefront. You know it's there. That way you know where to go from there. You need to know that you have something to actually work on. Second thing you need to do is you need to explain to your partner or your husband how his actions have affected the relationship. How has this impacted you? How has it impacted your relationship? They need to know, your partner needs to know the destruction that it has caused. Has it caused you guys to, that you absolutely can't trust him again? Do you feel, you know, super angry towards him? Do you feel hurt? Do you feel, you know, victimized? Do you feel, you know, disconnected and not emotionally in love that you did because you're so angry? You need to talk about how the actions of the cheating have impacted you as a person and have impacted your relationship. That's really important. The third thing you need to do, and this kind of goes with the talking about it, is you have to be 100% honest. Don't hold back your feelings. Obviously, you're going to be upset. You're going to be emotional when talking about this. So really, you know, don't be yelling. Don't be throwing things around. That makes it really unhelpful and unhealthy, an unhealthy dynamic. But you do want to be honest. So if you're crying, if you're upset, you know, if you're getting worked up in it, I mean, that's normal. That happens. You know, but you need to let your partner know how you feel. So don't hold back your emotions, because they do need to know the impact that it is having on you. And you want to be able to express your emotions in a healthy manner. The next step is, in order to talk about the cheating, you need to tell your partner what you need in order to repair the relationship. So You need to tell your partner, where do you want to go from here? You know, do you want to repair the relationship? Do you want to break up? Do you maybe want to separate for a little bit and get your mind clear and then come back together? You know, you need to tell your partner what the next steps are for what you want, what you need. Do you want to stay together and you want to work on things? You want to work on rebuilding the trust again? You need to be clear of what you want, because the ball is in your court. You know, you were cheated on, you are hurt, you are impacted, the trust is completely out the window. So after you talk about and you tell your husband that you know and you're honest and you're telling him how it impacts the relationship, you need to tell him, okay, well, what are the next steps in order to, you know, where do we go from here? And figure this out. So you want to talk about that piece. And then I think the most important piece to really know if he is sorry, and this is the key step, is you need to listen to his responses to all of the previous steps that you did. If he's justifying the situation, if he's not feeling sorry, if you can tell he's not remorseful or regretful, he's not sincere about it, then you are going to, like I said before, you're going to have a really hard uphill battle, and most likely you're not going to be able to repair the trust that has been broken. So you need to be able to know how to communicate after cheating happens to really know if you have something to work with, and you need to know if your relationship is repairable. You have a gut instinct, and I want you to trust what that is. So if your partner is really remorseful and sorry, and you know certain circumstances have led him to be doing what he did, you know, again, there's certain circumstances and situations that you can find forgivable if you choose to, and that's okay. I think a lot of people do feel guilty sometimes, you know, taking back a cheater, quote unquote, or staying in a relationship after infidelity, because that is a hard no for a lot of people, but it isn't a hard no for everybody. You know, there are ways to repair relationships that have been broken from infidelity and trust issues. So you need to listen to your husband to see how remorseful and how sorry he really, really is, and assess that and go with your gut instinct. And if you feel that there really is something to work with, then great. Then you are going to be able to take the next steps to repair the relationship. I have other videos that have to do with cheating, you know, the signs that he's cheating, you know, all the other things. Look at my other videos. You'll see other, you know, cheating videos out there. So I want you to click on those, because I think I have a lot of helpful tips on other videos that I have as well. So yes, if you have any questions about what we talked about today, please ask me below, comment, ask me any questions. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Okay. This is Kristen from KristenCoaching.com, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.